dear student, we have come here to explain revision of chapter 1 because after long time I could make out a video for you after two tests. So I don't know how much you have given tests. Some of you are pouring in the test papers in WhatsApp and some of you are not. So please compile with the WhatsApp woman because there should be good communication between you and me. I must know what is your doubt. Some of the students has beautifully written the problem they are facing, especially class 7 students, even others. And I'd like to know your problem first and then go accordingly. But even then, I'd like to go for revision of this chapter. And first, I would like to start with this topic. One topic, I left it because your test was ahead. So I left it a bit untouched, that is your calculation of speed. So first you have to understand this is altogether different because this chapter we're dealing with measurements, and all other measurements like volume and all this stuff are almost similar type. But when you talk about speed, we are talking a bit different topic. Actually, this is bit higher topic. So I'll repeat this, and speed means distance by time. You can see here it's clearly mentioned in your book. These all the pages are of your book. Some of you are, if you are facing problem with your book, you're not sure about. Some of the students ask me in WhatsApp, so I'm answering to that. If some of the books are doubtful, then you are not sure, then you just make sure from school whether you are using right book, or you can compare with the videos here and they will clearly tell you whether your books are correct. So we can say speed is nothing but speed. We can clearly mention speed is, we can clearly mention speed is, speed is equal to distance by time. Distance by time. So what does it mean, distance by time? When you talk about distance, see, suppose say some ram is moving from point A to B, fine, try to understand. And from A to B, Ram and Sham both are moving. So Ram is R and Sham is S, both are moving, and you are observing with the watch standing here, and you know Ram reaches earlier, so we declare Ram to be first and Sham to be second. By what? By time. Distance is same for both, but time taken by both are different. So we can say speed is equal to distance by time because distance is same for both the cases. So whose speed is more, Ram or Sham? Of course Ram is having higher speed, so speed of Ram we can very clearly say is much higher because the speed is distance by time. Distance by time, and distance is nothing. You know it very clearly, it's same for both the cases. If you compare with speed of Sham, it's all the same. Speed of Sham, that is also distance by time. Distance by time, and distance is both the cases are same. So if distance is same, then obviously you can say here very clearly, if distance is same, then you can say this is same, only this is different, time is different. Time taken by Ram is much less. Remember, this is a division ratio. So if denominator is small, the net value will be bigger. If denominator is big, net value will be small. So velocity of Sham is less than velocity of Ram, or speed, what you call it. It's all the same thing. Speed and velocity are same thing only. Now there's some conversion of units that is being shown here, and you have to be very conscious of this. Suppose we talk about conversion. So conversion from one unit to another, what do you do basically? What do you do here? Basically, if you have, they have given you 1 kilometer per hour and that you are going to convert. In the box you can see here, they have clearly mentioned 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, 1 minute is equal to 1/60, obviously unitary method, hours. That means 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. And 1 second is equal to 1/60 minutes. So that is multiplied 1/3600 hours. there may be a bit confusion because you're too tiny in class 7, so you may be facing a problem. So let me give you one day, let me calculate, I'll calculate one day in seconds. We know one day is 24 hours. So if one day is 24 hours, you are going to, this is 24 hours. And one, how many minutes makes 1 hour? 60 minutes makes 1 hour. That means one day is equal to 24 into 60. 24 hours into 60 minutes. So this many value will be our minutes. One day is equal to 24 hours, first conversion you have done. Now day in terms of minutes I'm going to find out. So I'll simply find out 24 into 6, 0 is considered directly. So you just multiply 24 into 6, 6 fours are 24, carry 2, 12, 14, that's all. So 1440 minutes is a day. Now I know how much is one day in seconds. That means one day is equal to 1440 minutes. And how many seconds makes a minute? We know 60 seconds makes 1 minute. Therefore, what we can say, these many minutes, 1440 minutes, will be multiplied with 60 seconds. Because unitary method, you bring it down, so it becomes, you are converting day into minutes. Just not reverse, I am showing you the reverse. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 1 second is equal to 1 by 60. 1 minute, if I write other way around, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, then 1 second is equal to 60 minutes. 1 by 60 minutes, seconds. So you just multiply this and you get 144, that is written here. I don't need to multiply with 6. See, remember all this. Zero zeros are not going to create a problem. Simply bring them at the end. After the, we also write them 10 to the power of 2 because 2 zeros are there. So you just bring them later. First you multiply them. 6 fours are 24 and carry 2. 6 fours are 24, 26. Plus 2 means 26, carry 2, 6, 1, 6, 7, 8. We have 8, so we have 0, 0, these two zeros. So answer is 8, 6, 4, 0, 0 seconds. That means one day have 86,400 seconds in all. One day, that is 24 hours. That means we can easily find out any conversion of time. We mean to say the time, which you have done only time. In this division, they are saying 1 kilometer. Now, millicentury, decimeter, decahecto, kilometer, I have given in my previous videos. You know it very well. By this time, you by heart, I guess. So, 1 kilometer is 1,000 meter. If this is 1,000 meter, you have divided by 3600. Why? Hour. How much is hour? 1 hour is, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. You want to convert 1 hour into seconds. So 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So that means 60 minutes is equal to 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. That means 60, you want to know the exact value of 1 hour, that is 60 minute. 60 minute will be equal to 60 into 60. Into 60, because this 60 in second, now there is no more minute. So this becomes 36 and 00 seconds. So this becomes your 3600 seconds. Am I clear? So this is how you go for conversion, how you actually convert one system to another. Now I'll go to some questions. You have to be very clear about the questions, because without understanding questions, you cannot handle it properly. Yes, so here the question comes, we have discussion actually, some before the questions we have some discussions, Let's see how actually it works. Solve problems. Calculate distance. In the above also we have another problem that is worked out. So I leave it up to some worked out to you that 5 by 8. This is one standard value. In my previous lecture I discussed about this. If you remember, I discussed about this very clearly. This is about the uniform value, that 1 meter per second. You can remember this. 1 meter per second is equal to 18 by 5 kilometer per hour. So you can remember this always. You can simply remember this always. That will help you to understand this. To convert 1 meter second to kilometer per hour, the value needs to be multiplied by this. This is the value. You can remember 18 by 7. If you want to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour, you just multiply, otherwise you divide by this. So this has to be remembered. Now here they say the distance between two stations is 192 kilometers. A train takes 3 hours to cover this distance. Distance they have given, time they have given, just divide it, find the value. Bike travels at a speed of 40 kilometers per hour to cover a distance of 120 kilometer. What would be the time taken by the bike to complete the journey? Time they are asking. In this they are asking you speed. See, what they are asking you to find out, you have to understand this first. In this question, they are asking you time. They have given you speed. Here they have given you speed. They have given you distance. They are asking you time. It's a very simple sum. Third question. The distance of 6 km is covered by two wheelers in 8 minutes. What would be the speed of the car? So here they are again asking you speed. So these are not critical questions. They may ask you even critical questions, but these are very simple questions. 6 km distance they have given, time they have given 8 minutes. So easily find out the speed. It's very simple answer. This is your question mark here, and you find out this. So this is how you handle these numericals. Similar type of numericals may come. Some keywords are very important here, like volume. You have to understand very clearly. Volume is nothing but, if this is my structure, suppose that this is a structure like this, I consider this is my volume, this is my volume, where I consider, if I know this, and if I know this, length, breadth and height, I can easily find out volume. Now capacity is the amount of liquid container a container can hold. Suppose this is a container, the amount of liquid that can be contained in it. Suppose we give some liquid here, the amount of liquid that can be contained in this container is the capacity. Bigger tank have bigger capacity, and we also, you have seen overhead tanks, we say 600 liters, 500 liters, 1000 liters, so on and so forth. That is the capacity of the tank. And density is one of the crucial topic. Density I already discussed and in my previous videos, and density is mass per unit volume. Mass definition is clear to you. Mass per unit volume. Why? Suppose, say, this is my container, a fixed volume I take. I take one volume, this container full of milk. First I take milk, and then the same volume, I wash it properly, dry it properly, and I take some water. Now tell me, which will be heavy? Milk is much heavier than water. So amount of milk, the simple logic, go by simple logic, in your junior classes also we have done, milk is higher density, means what? Their molecules are nearby, very close. So number of molecules in this volume of milk will be more than number of molecules of water in this volume, because water is far off molecules in comparison to milk. So that is actually serious topic of density we are talking about. Density means, now how you see this? Suppose, say, number of molecule will dictate to how much is the material content of the body, which is mass. So in this amount of volume, how much mass is contained, it will be dictated by the number of molecules in it. So it is very clear that milk will be having higher mass, because number of molecules in the same volume is same. In the same volume for both milk and water, number of molecules are more in that volume of milk than water, then mass is more. If upper one, the numerator is more, density is bound to be more. If numerator is less, density is bound to be less, because for this case we have maintained volume to be same. the same volume. This is our volume here. We have used this. Whatever it may be, that means density is a serious issue. We talk about density in all our aspects, and that is one of the crucial topic we have to discuss. Now next we'll be going to some exercises, and exercise is essential for us because without that you don't get maturity of your topic. Now once you talk about density here, then we have to be very serious that mass, volume and density relation may come. When you talk about exercise, see the first question. Choose the correct answer from each of the following. SI unit of volume is, of course, I have given already answers, but even then I'd like to discuss it because this is one of the crucial topic and you should understand it very clearly. SI unit of volume is, of course, meter cube. You go and just stick by this meter cube, because we simply talk about the volume. So volume is length, breadth and height product. So length is in meter, in SI unit, but the breadth is in meter, and also our height is also in meter. So this is our correct answer. Kg is the unit of mass, Newton meter is unit of work done, and Newton per meter is something else. So nothing is relevant, only m cube is the answer. Which of the following this represents the correct relation between speed, distance and time? Of course you know the formula, speed is equal to distance upon time. So you see the answer, distance is equal to, they have given twisted. This is not correct, because speed is equal to distance by time, divided by time. So this is incorrect. Speed is equal to time by distance. No, this is also incorrect. Distance is equal to speed by time. So time goes this side. Speed is equal to distance by times, but it is, and so this is also incorrect. But this seems to be correct, because speed is equal to, they have given speed into time, so time can be taken this side. So this turns to speed is equal to distance by time. You can take this time down. So this is the correct answer. Here comes the formula used to calculate the density of substance. Definition of density. Density is mass per unit volume. This is the only correct answer. Mass per unit volume. Mass per volume. So obviously this is density. SI unit of density is. Now see, sometime you're in trouble with SI units. Don't hesitate. You can easily answer them. Very clearly answer them, because we can talk about the density with the formula, because we know the definition and we can go by definition here. Density is equal to mass per volume. So mass is in kg and volume is in meter cube. So SI unit I have mentioned. See, this is 1 gram per meter cube. This is wrong, because gram is in CGS system, not SI, and m cube is in meter. So let's look for m cube and kg. Kg is this unit of mass in SI unit. So mass per unit volume. So this is the answer, because kg per meter cube will be in the SI. Sorry. Odometer is a device that is used to determine the what? Speed of the vehicle. Time taken by the vehicle. Time is, of course, what is the time? Distance traveled by the vehicle? No, none of the above. Of course not none of the speed of the vehicle. How fast the vehicle is moving. Speedometer or odometer we call it. So that is going to give you exact picture of the speed by which, and that is in your book. You can easily see that in your book. Now fill up the gap. The SI unit of dash is meter per second. Of course, meter per second, distance by time. This is speed. This is the correct answer. Speed. And speed is the distance covered by a body in unit dash. Time, unit length of time. Speed is the distance covered by unit time. Of course, unit time. This is the answer. You have to write here time. And see, the volume of a spherical marble with radius 1 centimeter is. Now, volume of a, the formula for volume. Volume is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now, some of you have been test. I have checked the question answers. Pi, you are taking very confused way. So, we can write here. Let me do it here. Volume is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. So pi is can be taken as 22 by 7 or 3.14. So I'll prefer to take 3.15 because that is a bit mature calculated, 3.14. R is they have given 1 centimeter. Answer is also in centimeter. You see this, answer is in centimeter, so you don't need to convert it. The option, if they would have given in meters, then you need to be converting this, but now you don't need to convert it. So 3.14, this is 3.14, and into R cube. R is 1 centimeter, so keep it 1 centimeter, 1 cube. See, by giving 1, they have gifted you actually. You don't need to calculate anything. Only calculation you have is actually 4 by 3 into 3.14. So, how to calculate this? If you are going to calculate this, you are going to find it a bit tough because this is 3. So, 4 is not a problem. I won't go to complication. There are some Vedic methods for easy calculation. But online I won't take that risk because you are already away from me. So otherwise in normal classes I would have showed you the easy technique to calculate this. Now let me handle this. That means this is 4 into 3.14 can be written as 314 into 10 to the power of minus 2 because this is 0.2. Two digits after decimal sign, so that can be written as 10 to the power of minus 2. Then minus 2 means it is, this can be written as, you can consider, actually I can write it here separately, 3.14 can be written as 314 divided by 100 because two zeros down, so that can be again written as 314 into 10 to the power of 2 because this goes up, so this becomes minus 2 what I have written here. So you have actually 4 into 314. This is rough work I'm doing. 314 into 4. So how much is this? 4 4s are 16, and carry 1 4 5 and 12, and this is your answer. But with 2, so you have 12.6. This comes to 12.56 12 by 3. So 12.56 by 3, again if you want to divide it, you can easily divide it. 1256. 0.2 you can separately bring it later. Divide this by 3. 4 3s are 12, so this becomes 12. This becomes 5, so this becomes 1, so this becomes 3 and 2, and then you bring 6 6 26. So 4 3 12 are 36, and this can go 3 8s are 24.